Are you
The House
aware?
Committees on Public Accounts and Good Government and Public Accountability urged PhilHealth to pay only for the expenses of confirmed COVID-19 patients.
Let me just follow up dun sa binanggit ni Honorable Kimbo into a formal motion to strongly urge the PhilHealth to withdraw the policy for suspected and probable COVID cases as part of their circular and resolution approved by the board.
Marikina Representative Stella Kimbo says it's unacceptable for both confirmed and suspect or probable COVID cases to be treated equally by PhilHealth.
Dapat po isuspend ang liquidation para sa non-COVID claims. And siguro idagdag ko na rin dyan, baka pwede na rin natin isuspend po, Mr. Chair, ang pag-apply ng COVID case rates para sa suspected or probable patients.
Kimbo, citing PhilHealth data, pointed out that of the 458 hospitals that have liquidated their interim reimbursement mechanism funds, 346 or 75% had no COVID-19 patient. That means zero claims from the 1.2 billion pesos disbursed to 346 hospitals or clinics from the IRM. Seven healthcare facilities who have liquidated 100% of their IRM showed they only had non-COVID cases. 17 healthcare facilities had zero COVID claims after liquidating 75% of their IRM allocations. Kimbo fears actual COVID-19 cases may be left with no funds.
Ang problema kasi dito is since naubos na ang pondo, paano po kung talagang may legit na may COVID na nagpunta po dito sa mga facilities na to? Baka sila po ay may ma-turn away nang dahil po wala nang pondo na naka-park po sa kanilang mga accounts.
IRM po was adopted already as a special privilege in times of fortuitous events and emergencies.
In the meantime, PhilHealth's board named its Executive Vice President and COO Arnel De Jesus as officer in charge following the resignation of PhilHealth President Ricardo Morales. But lawmakers note De Jesus is dealing with medical problems that have kept him from attending congressional hearings. Malacañang is in no hurry to name a replacement for Morales, only to spell out what makes an ideal successor. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque adds, despite his resignation, Morales is not yet off the hook.
Wala naman pong timeline kung kailan po magtatalaga ng kapalit si Presidente. Pero kinakailangan po ang talagang iuupo dyan ay walang bahid ng korupsyon. The law is very clear. If there is criminal liability incurred when you are in office, it subsists and public officers can be held liable for them whether or not they continue to be in office.
Deputy Speaker Rodante Marcoleta went after Civil Service Commission Chair Alicia De La Rosa Bala for an old case and the CSE's amendment of requirements and qualifications for PhilHealth officials.
Tungkol dun sa request for amendment, it's more of amendment. It's very clear in the decision of the commission. Okay. And this was signed, both of us, Commissioner Lizada and myself. So there's the qualification standards states education, master's degree or certificate in leadership and management.
Ang nakikita po ninyo is a pattern. Imbes na po ang civil service talagang gawin ang tungkulin, ituwid ang pagkakamali, silang maging kasangkapan para palutangin ang totoo. Ang pattern kasi malinaw, Mr. Chair. Napakilak ng pattern. Nakikita ko yung sabuatan, mga PhilHealth, mga DepEd. Mr. Chairman,
Honorable Marcoleta,
pwede mo bang pahiram sa akin yung martilyo mo para bumaba lang?
Bala denies allegations she suppressed information on cases related to PhilHealth pending before the CSC despite a video recording purportedly saying otherwise. This video recording of what is said to be a CSC meeting was played during the congressional hearing.
I hope that this information should be within the commission and should never be shared with the public or to whoever will be asking us this. In aid of legislation or investigation.
I'm categorically stating that as the CSC chairperson, I made no directive, guidance, or insinuations for the commission to suppress information in any case.
The CSC chief says they've already submitted a list of the pending cases to the House panels, even as she maintained they do not handle corruption cases. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.